colon cancer is the leading preventable cause of death in the US. Everybody should know that colon cancer is preventable. By doing screening colonoscopies, we can remove those precancerous polyps and therefore prevent cancers and save lives.
Polyps and early tumors are often not symptomatic. So it's not as though one can wait for symptoms to develop, then see the doctor and expect that then one will have the best outcomes.
The idea is that you want to go in at least 10 years before a problem's going to occur. So typically, the peak years for colon cancer to develop are in the 60s, and that's the reason we start looking at 50.
When you go to your colonoscopy, they give you a little sedation, and the next thing you know, you're waking up saying, are we done? It is no big deal. The next point is, who is at increased risk over the general population? People who have a family history of colorectal polyps or cancer are at increased risk, so they need to be screened earlier. Other issues that put you at increased risk. It's known that patients with Crohn's and ulcerative colitis are at increased risk for colorectal cancer.
We know that there are subgroups who are at higher risk. A particular group of concern is African Americans. They have a higher risk of colorectal cancer and may also have a higher risk of dying of colorectal cancer.
When anyone's diagnosed with colon cancer, they will be examined for a gene called RAS and some other genes that help tell us if a certain treatment might be more effective or less effective, and to help determine if their family may have a higher than average cancer incidence.
Patients often ask what they can do in their daily life to decrease the risk of colon or rectal cancer. There is evidence that a healthy diet, rich in fruits and vegetables, low in fat, high in fiber, may be beneficial. Avoiding smoking, maintaining a good weight, diminishing the risk factors that may lead to diabetes and metabolic syndrome. All of these things can decrease the risk of forming polyps or developing colorectal cancer.
Like all common cancers, if you can catch them early and take them out, they are quite curable, and so surgery is still a mainstay for this cancer unless it's spread outside the colon.
Those patients basically have nodal involvement of their cancer. So those patients benefit from surgical resection of the tumor, followed by 6 months of chemotherapy.
But even in stage four patients, where we used to say this was incurable and that sort of thing, we have found that we've had great success in treating patients with stage four cancers.
Our chemotherapies are so much better than they were 10 years ago. It's not the same disease anymore. We have the ability to control the disease, eradicate the disease, and so very challenging situations are brought under control and patients are cured. The number of people that I've taken care of that have been told that this is it and that we've cured of cancer, that have gone on to live many, many years, is really remarkable.
So for patients, thinking about where they can get outstanding care, what we promise is that we will evaluate their condition very carefully and bring the best that is available in current medical science to improve their health outcomes, and also to make available to them the latest research. So whether somebody has a simpler condition or a more complicated condition, we aim to provide that for the patient and to serve their needs.